I want to talk about the strategic rationale of the deal and whether you like it, but before I even get to that, can you explain how the stocks have moved this morning?
Well, I mean, a typical premium, obviously, for the acquired shares, and a bit of a ding for the acquirer. I think the market's sort of looking at a price environment for crude oil, Andrew, that's, mediocre. You look out on the forward curve all the way out to 2028 on the NYMEX price board futures, they're trading around $53 a barrel. So I wouldn't say we're in a very high price oil environment, nor though are we in a super low one. We're really in the middle ground. I think it's sort of an area where, you know, the deals are going to get done. And I think that there's probably some question out there as to whether or not some of these really remarkable data points that have been put out by Chevron about this in terms of it being, for example, free cash flow after just a single year here after what they're paying. And given the potential for the ups and downs of the price environment, particularly in the Permian, where the assets, I think, here are dominant. So I think that's why you're seeing a little bit of, you know, qualms in the market for Chevron's shares and even Anadarko's at this point.
John, when you heard the news, your first reaction was what?
Well, wow. I mean, this is obviously a huge deal, but it also just struck me how I've been saying that the adults have come to the party in the shale play. ExxonMobil, a couple of weeks ago, you guys had the CEO on. He talked about how they have their costs in the shale down to $18 at $35.40. He was talking about double-digit returns. They have cracked the code. The smaller guys, and you saw Pioneer Resources announce potential for layoffs and the culling of their workforce because they're getting squeezed. They can't generate the cost efficiencies that the ExxonMobils and now clearly the Chevrons can, Andrew. Right. So it's clearly now a game where we're getting the big players in there, and they may inflict production discipline down the road.
Interesting.
That could make
John,
the,
we got to run. Is there one or two targets we should look at in terms of other stocks you think are going to move as a result of this transaction this morning?
Definitely Pioneer, and I would say Devon and Occidental.